So in this test, we are going to be looking for the presence of vitamin C. The other name for vitamin C is ascorbic acid. That's probably more commonly referred to if you look at any food labels. So the way that we're going to test for this is we're going to use an endophenol solution. And so this dye is going to be reduced by vitamin C if it's present, and it's going to go from this dark blue color to a more colorless state. And so we're going to have a negative control with just DI water and a positive control that we're going to have with vitamin C. So these two test tubes have 5 milliliters of water in them. I'm going to do the positive control first. So we're going to add 20 drops of this to each solution. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So again, make sure to mix it up really well. You can see it's this very deep purple blue color, and we are going to look for the decoloration of this reaction, which will indicate that endophenol has been reduced. So this is kind of an interesting reaction because we're just gonna keep adding vitamin C and keep mixing as we go until we start to see a reaction. So there's no set volume that you're gonna use. We're just going to keep adding some vitamin C as we go. So I'm gonna add a little bit here, and I'm gonna start to just swirl it. And you can see as I swirl, interact more of that vitamin C, I start to have a decoloration of the solution. So as I continue to shake, that endophenol is being reduced by the vitamin C. And if I were to add a little bit more vitamin C, I might be able to do it without it. So this was adding about 1 milliliter of vitamin C, was enough to fully reduce the endophenol in this solution. And your end result should be a clearer color. It's not gonna be exactly clear as like water, but you should be able to see a clearing of that dark blue. So the more vitamin C it has, the more clearing you're going to be able to identify. So again, it's going to be a lot of vitamin C, we'll have a full clearing, and that's going to be a very lightly pink solution and much more transparent than what originally started as. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna add the same amount of water. So I'm gonna measure out about 1 milliliter of water here, which is about the amount that I added of my ascorbic acid. And I'm gonna shake it up. And you can see if it's a negative, there's going to be no color change. That solution is going to remain that deep, dark blue-black color. And it's not going to decolorize at all. So negative control, you'll have no loss of color. It's going to stay that deep, dark blue. The more vitamin C you have, the more you're going to have that clearing, that decolorization occur.